Welcome back, dear my new students, to this new lecture. Today we are going to take another properties of water, and today we are talking about the biological properties of water and how to detect and what is the meaning of the biological properties of water. Here we can, so as you know, we have the most important thing in studying the biological properties of water quality is to know how much is the safe water to be in terms of biological properties. So we have to know that there is some diseases that will be that's called waterborne diseases that will be transported via water. And this is due to the presence of bacteria, viruses, and protozoa. These are the microorganisms are when they are existing in the water, then they will burn a disease to the people. For example, we have bacteria here, as you see in this slide. In the bacteria, we have Salmonella bacteria, which cause typhoid fever. It's a kind of fever, this is the enteric fever. Also, we have cholera diseases. This is also due to the bacteria that we have, and this is called cholera bacterium. Also, we have dysentery, and so there's the dysentery is another bacteria water disease born. Also, some of the diseases are due to the viruses, like the hepatitis viruses that we have, and also we have protozoa. It's an amoebic dysentery. That's also it's a kind of microorganism. So in general, we have two types of bacteria: iron and sulfur bacteria. The iron bacteria, it causes in terms of physical properties, in terms of water networks, they causes tuberculation in the pipes, and also make a kind of water to be rendered and unsuitable for industrial purposes. This is if we have an iron bacteria, and also we have sulfur bacteria. So sulfur bacteria also make a kind of metabolism, and it's destructive when it is used in the concrete and other structural building materials. The most important microorganisms are called pathogens. So pathogens are a kind of microorganisms that when they are in the water, so it's biologically polluted water. The examples of these, so every bacteria, viruses, protozoa are and helminth are is called in general, and in all they are called pathogens. We have in terms of shapes, we can classify the bacteria and the pathogens like spherical shape, like rod shaped bacteria, coma shaped, and spiral or spiralium shaped bacteria. So pathogen bacteria can be tested. Now here's the what the most important thing here: how to test, how to know the both a sample of water is now polluted or in terms of biological. So we have to know is there is the presence of pathogens are there in the sample of water or not, and so the presence of that, so we have to know whether there is bacteria, viruses, or protozoa, which is a kind of difficulty because they are in terms of micrometers. But we have three methods to count this kind of pathogens in terms of in sample of water. In general, we can't do the counts for all of them, for all of the pathogen types, bacteria, viruses. But the only one thing that is common between the whole pathogens that we have, if there is a coliform microorganisms, the coliform microorganisms, if there were prisons, there are this is the presence of coliform bacteria means the presence of pathogens. Coliform in general, coliforms are, as I said, they are themselves are harmless. These are harmless aerobic lactose fermentators organisms. So but coliforms are microorganisms or organisms that are the, in themselves are they are in themselves are not harming people. But why we are we can we use it we use to measure pathogens, we will measure the path the coliform because the presence or absence of this coliforms will means the presence and absence of the pathogen bacteria itself. So here is the common things between the all kind of bacteria. When we have coliform presence means there is pathogen, there is bacteria in the water. If there was no coliforms, it means that the sample of water is clean. And as I said, coliforms are harmless. They are not harming people. It's a kind of sugar lactose fermentator organisms. And this is the shape of this shape, as you can see, there is in terms of 1 micrometers. 1 micrometers, it means 10 to the power milli micro nano. So it means 10 to the power 6 meters of measurement of the rod. This is a rod shaped coliform. In general, coliforms, we have coliform bacteria, it's called B. coli or E. coli, are very important, harmless. These are the anaerobic, so like I said, this is an aerobic microorganism. As we said, we have coliforms, we have aerobic, we have coliform inaerobic or anaerobic. And as I said, the bacteria live longer in water than the pathogen bacteria. So these the coliforms are live longer than the. So if the there is if there was the presence of coliform bacteria, means definitely there is a pathogens in water. The absence of the coliform bacteria also it deny that there is any kind of pathogens a sample of water. These are the three methods that used to find whether we have coliform bacteria or pathogen bacteria or the sample was polluted by in terms of biological or not. First one is the second kind of difficulty, but we have this is a membrane filter technique. We use a membrane filter technique to measure the pathogen, the coliforms, and through the coliforms we know is there the more dense of coliforms, the more dense of the pathogen of water. Also, we have another a method that's nowadays are most used in the in finding or measuring the biological properties of water, which is called most probable number, M most, P probable number, N number, most probable number of the bacteria. So it's another method that is used to measure the biological properties of water. The last method or the last we have another method which is called coliform index. starting from the first method to measure, which is using the membrane or filter, membrane filter. The idea is that we have a filter membrane. The membrane means that it's a kind of filter, and we will pass through this membrane water. The sample will be poured with this one, and after that we will put a sterilized membrane, a culture media. The culture media, it why we are putting nutrients to see whether this bacteria will, because we need to measure, we need to see if there's bacteria and this bacteria will be growth or not. So we need to know somehow some kind of food to this bacteria, and then after that, after 24 hours, we will measure by using the microscopes how much colonies we have. By the way, every bacteria will be multiplied and growth and become a colony. So a colony is it was one bacteria, and then after that it will become a dot. So each dot is a growth of one bacteria, and then we have specific volume that was filtered through this media, and then after that we will measure the number of colonies or the dots that we have. So the more colonies, it means the more coliform was there in the sample of water, and then definitely it means that there is a pathogen, there is microorganism, there is bacteria in this water. The absence of coliform bacteria, it means the absence of colonies, the absence of colonies, the absence of the bacteria, the absence of bacteria, it means the absence of pathogens in water, and it means that, and in drinking water, so we shouldn't have any kind of coliform bacteria. Here I want you to take in practice how to measure, and start from here. We have to take a sample of water. Here we are taking the sample of water. This sample of water, this container should be sterilized before using it. You have to be sterilized, and we have to be dark enough not to have sunlight, because the sunlight will affect on the bacteria, if there was bacteria, and it will make the lactose to be used. So we have to be aware of this one. Now after that, after taking the sample of water, okay, this is from a stream. We have quickly to take the sample to the lab, and here's I want you to see the step of how to use this. Steps procedure in the lab. First of all, this is the sample of water, and after that this is the membrane. I have the membrane. This is the filtration device. This is called filtration device. This filtration device is used vacuum. It's a vacuum pump. It's suctioning the air from this from the container, so that to let the water to be poured through the filter membrane. And after that, after the filtration complete, we will take back this filter media membrane, and then we will put culture nutrients inside this can, and then after 24 hours, and before that we will put a detector. Detector, it means a type of color or a dye its color will be changed with the existence of the lactose in this. Maybe it will be turned into the blue or red. That's if we are going to test for the total coliform bacteria, and it will turn into black or dark blue if you are going to measure the fecal coliform bacteria. And I will let you know how to what is the difference between total and the total coliform bacteria? Is the bacteria or is the kind of organisms that are existing in the ground? So whenever you have a sample of water that it's containing total coliform bacteria, it means that source of the pollution is from the land. When we have fecal coliform bacteria in this sample of water, it means that we have source of pollutions are due to the mammals or animals and so on. Now start again back to the procedure, back to this lab. As we say that this is the difference between coliform bacteria are usually the existence from the fecal from the mammals, and the total coliforms will be exist in the soil, as you can see. And this is the growth of bacteria. It becomes colonies, it dies, it's gross. And here's we can see if this is we are going to test for total coliform bacteria. Total coliform bacteria, as we say, the source of the bacteria that it's. This is the result. The result after the end of the test, you can see this is the membrane. This is called the membrane. This is the membrane, and we put in the beginning before. This is the incubation period. We have to let the sample and water, the filter, the port water from the filter membrane for 24 hours in an incubator. Incubator, it means that we have 35 degrees Celsius constant temperature, and already we put a dye, it means an indicators, and you can see the red one E. coli, and the other one, the others are coliform bacteria. So we have to measure like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are, so we have to measure the dots and the measurements. So how many dots that we have, it means the number of the colonies or the number of bacteria per how much the volume of the measured or the filtered water through this one. This is with regards of the coliform bacteria. And also we have for fecal coliform bacteria. Fecal coliform bacteria, as we said, this is the existence of the intestine of the mammals that we have. This you can see here is the dots here also. So how many dots we have, it means how much is the number of the colonies and the bacteria is there. The difference between the test of fecal coliform bacteria and fecal coliform bacteria and total coliform bacteria is that the total coliform bacteria sample membrane should be kept in an incubator for 35 degrees Celsius, while for the fecal coliform bacteria we have to make it in 44.5 degrees Celsius and in 24 hours. That usually used water bath. Why with this one? Because we want to simulate the same environment that the fecal coliforms are lived in. Back to the procedure of this one. So we will start. Here's the sample of water, as you can see. This is called the device that's used for measuring or putting the membrane inside it. And first of all, we have to label the two containers for measuring, the one for the total coliform bacteria, and this is the one, and the other one for fecal coliform. And by the way, this is the membrane that we are using. Using this kind of this is a membrane that we are using. This is a membrane. usually the pack, this pack, it contains two things. One, membrane. This pack contains membrane and nutrient. Nutrient pad and membrane pad. This is so they are existing in one pack, and we have to use both of them. One, we will put the membrane filter in this device. This is the membrane, it will be here, and the nutrient, which is used for culturing the bacteria, will be put it in this plate. Okay, now back to the video procedure. Yeah, here is the how to put the, this is the vacuum of the filtration device. We have to be to put it carefully in this one, and then the nutrient, here's the nutrient, yes, pad, it should be placed for as a cultural device in this plate. Now it's the time to put the color. This is a color, a dye, which is interact with the lactose due to the reaction of the coliform organisms, and then the dots will be appear. After that, we have to use first of all the sample of water. We have to take we will use take 10 milliliters of the samples of water, and then afterward we have to add another 19 ml of decentralized water, clean water, sterilized water plus the samples. That means I am using a dilution of 1 to 100, 10% or say 10 ml sample for 100 ml. Now I'm using dilution, so after when we the result should be multiplied by 10. Why? Because the 10 is the number of the inverse of 10 divided by 100. I'm using from the sample of water only 10 ml, 10 cc, and after that we will add only clean water, decentralized, sterilized water, 90 ml, and after that we use this sample, this 100 ml, and filtered through the membrane. Now yes, sorry about that. Yes, so labeling, after labeling we have to put the pad, and this is the filtration membrane, and then using the pad inside this one again. And by the way, this is very expensive, the pad, we have to be aware not to. Okay, now we will start putting the dyes. As I said, this is only for if you can use it for a reaction of the lactose, and that will be produced through the interaction of the coliform organisms. Yes, now we used 10 ml of the sample. This is the 10 ml. This is B 10 ml. And we have to then make a dilution, use a clean water to make it as 100 ml. And then you pour the sample of 100 ml in and a device to filter the sampa, and this is the vacuum pump here. This is a vacuum pump, and we have to be aware when you are using. So the vacuum will be suctioning air from this device, and then the water, this is the filtered water, this is the sump, will be poured through the membrane. And then, because I want, after the vacuum is finished, so I will turn this filter membrane carefully and directly put it to a, yes, put it here in this machine. Okay, now I have to rape the I have to band very carefully and make for incubation, and upside down, it should be upside down for 24 hours in a 37 degrees Celsius. And also for total that was for total coliform. For E. coli, we have to put it in 45, yeah. Fecal coliform bacteria, we have to make it in 45, a water bath. Now, after the 24 hours, now we are going to measure the dots. And we have, here's the dots, it appears. And here's the dots. And you can see here's the dots. And the dots means the number of the colonies. And the number of colonies are there. Yes, here's that for the total coliform bacteria. You can see we have blue, we have red, and we are using, we are measuring the dots. So when we measure this one, I say this is one, this is two, because this is a colony, this is a three, this is a four, and so on. Okay. Now we have to be aware that, so a number of each colony means one bacteria. Then we will measure the number of the colonies there, and then multiply by, this is in 10 mole, and because the sample was for 100 mole, so I have to be aware that the number should be multiplied by 10. And after that, so we have to be aware, multiplying the number of dots by 10, it means that because the dilution was 400 mole, and if we use the sample of water by 50 mole, now if this is the sample of water, some of them they use only 10 mole, and then increase or add in 19 mole of distilled water, then the result will be multiplied by 10. If you dilute it only, or if you took from the sample of water just 15 mole and adding only 15 mole for distilled water, then it means you are diluting twice, so the result or the number of the dots should be multiplied by 2, not by 10, and you have to be aware. This is one of the procedures that we used in measuring the total coliform bacteria and fecal coliform bacteria, which are the two most important biological tests of water quality. I hope it was this video was interesting to you, and see you next lecture with the other two methods on how to use the most probable numbers to measure the coliform bacteria. Thank you, and have a nice day.